फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू दिस वीडियो। टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट होमोलोगस सीरीज एंड नोमेनक्लेचर ऑफ कार्बन कंपाउंड्स इन दिस वीडियो। सपोज वी डिवाइडेड मेनी बुक्स अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर सब्जेक्ट, दैट इज ऑल द बुक्स ऑफ हिंदी, इंग्लिश, साइंस एटसेट्रा वर केप्ट सेपरेटली। As its name suggests, homologous carbon compounds can be defined as a group of similar type of carbon compounds that have the same general formula and functional group. The alkane hydrocarbon series are as follows: methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, etc. In moving from one unit to another unit, there is a difference of CH2 unit. For example, there is a difference of CH2 unit from methane to ethane. There is also a difference of CH2 from ethane to propane, propane to butane, butane to pentane. And as you can see, we can represent any compound of this category by CnH2n plus 2 by this formula. For example, in the first compound of the series methane, n will be 1. Now, if we write 1 instead of n in this formula, we will get molecular formula of methane CH4. All carbon compounds in this category belong to a single bond, and so an will be added at the end of the name, such as methane, ethane, etc. It also means that there is a difference of 14 mass between one unit to another unit. Because the mass of CH2 is 14, as the mass increases in the homologous series, the mass of the molecule will increase. If the hydrocarbon compound contains carbon-carbon double bond, then that category will be called alkene. That is, ene will be added at the end of the name. For example, ethylene, propene, butene, pentene, etc. In this series too, there is a difference of CH2 unit in moving from one unit to another. And as you can see, we can show CnH2n, any compound of this category, by this formula. For example, in the second compound, ethene, the N will be 2. Now, if we write 2 instead of N in this formula, we will find the molecular formula C2H4 of ethene. Similarly, if the hydrocarbon compound contains carbon-carbon triple bond, the series will be called alkyne. The name will end with "-ine". And the same important thing is that there will be a difference of CH2 unit in moving from one unit to another. And we can show any compound in this carbon series by this formula: CnH2n minus 2. Let us now understand that what functional group is called, such as OH, alcohol, Cl, chlorine, Br, bromine, etc. This functional group gives compounds special characteristics. When another group displaces a hydrogen inside a hydrocarbon, it is called a functional group. For example, take alcohol, OH. If an OH alcohol group is added instead of a hydrogen of methane hydrocarbon, the name OL will be added to form methanol. Similarly, the entire homologous series is composed methanol, ethanol, propanol, butanol, pentanol, etc. You must have understood by now that this is a homologous category of alcohol, and here too, CH2 has to be added to move from one unit to the next. And moving from one unit to the next unit changes 14 mass. And because they all have the same functional group OH, they all have similar chemical properties. Similarly, you can form homologous categories by placing different functional groups in hydrocarbon groups. So now you must have understood a series of compounds in which the same functional group substitutes for hydrogen in a carbon chain is called a homologous series. The most important formula for this is that it takes 1 CH2 and 14 masses to move from one unit to another. When molecular mass increases in a homologous series, there is a gradation in physical properties. This is because the melting point and boiling point increase as the molecular mass increases. The chemical properties that are ensured by a purely functional group remain the same in the homologous series. Hope you will not have any dilemma related to homologous series. Let us now study the method of naming carbon compounds. Before understanding the nomenclature of carbon compounds, we will see an example of a name, like Mr. Mahendra Singh Dhoni. In this name, Mr. can be called prefix. Mahendra is the first name. Singh is the middle name and Dhoni is surname. Similarly, the name of carbon compounds is also divided into 5 parts. Let us know what those 5 parts are. The first part is the primary prefix. Then comes the second prefix. Then comes the carbon chain. Then comes the second attachment, which joins behind the name. And then comes the primary attachment. In this way, the name of our carbon compound is divided into 5 parts. Now, we will discuss the rules of this nomenclature. But it can be a bit difficult for you to understand at once. Because, like mathematics, you will need to practice it. By discussing it through examples, it will start easy to understand and you will be able to name any compound. Let's know about the nomenclature. See, first you have to tell about the substitution. Now, what is this replacement? Just like there are only carbon and hydrogen, it is called hydrocarbon. If inside it we remove any hydrogen and replace it with fluorine, because both hydrogen and fluorine form a bond with carbon. Similarly, chlorine, bromine or iodine can replace hydrogen. What is this now? These are substitutions. Because they have replaced hydrogen by replacing it, in English, it is called substitution. So far, we have discussed 4 substitutions. You will learn about more substitutions later. What to write if fluorine is added in carbon compounds? Write fluoro before the name, and if chlorine is added, chloro. If bromine is added, we will write bromo. And if iodine is added, then we will write iodo. So what is the first thing to look for in an organic compound? Will you see fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine? So we can write the primary prefix accordingly. After this, will you see which type of ring is being formed in carbon? You can easily see this. That is, the chain of carbon is straight or forming a ring. If the ring is formed, then you will use the word cyclo. Then you will come to the main carbon chain. How many carbons are there? If there is one carbon, then we will write meth. If there are two carbons, then we will write eth. If there are three carbons, then we will write prop. If there are four carbons, we will write butyl. If there are five carbons, then we will write pent. If there are six carbons, then we will write hex. If there are seven carbons, then we will write hept. If there are eight carbons, then we will write oct. If there are nine carbons, then we will write non. If 10 carbons, then we will write dec. You must remember this sequence very well. Now you can see whether the carbon is having single bond or double bond in the compound or triple bond. If there is a single bond, you will write ane. If there is a double bond, you will write ene. And if there is a triple bond, you will write ine. Now we can check the primary attachments are functional groups. They are as important as surname in carbon name. If OH or hydroxyl is seen in the primary, it is alcohol. For this, you will write OL. If you see CHO, that is aldehyde, you will write AL, AL for it. If you see COOH, this is carboxylic acid. For this, we will say OIC, oic acid. If you see CO, this is ketone, and you will write ONE for it. These are the magical formulae that once you have understood, you can write the name of any carbon compound. We will study the chemical reactions of carbon compounds in the next video.